Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to find the volume of this hexagonal cylinder over here. Alright, so here we have this shape, and please excuse my drawing, I really did do my best here. But we're going to figure out how do we find the volume of this. And when it comes to finding the volume, just in general, different shapes, we definitely need to make sure that we are pulling the correct formula for it, and that we have all the pieces that we need to plug into the formula. So when it comes to finding the volume of this, so our formula is equal to, volume is equal to the area of the face of that. So for us, it's a hexagon. So we're going to do the area of the hexagon times the height, or really in the length here, because this is kind of sitting more on its side. So this is the formula that we need. Now, remember that this A I mentioned, this is the area of the face here. Right, so this is an area of the face of our shape. So here we have a hexagon. So we're going to first need to figure out how do we find the area of this. And then once we have that, we're going to multiply it by the height of this, which essentially is the length here. How tall is it? So first off, so area of a hexagon, we also need to pull that formula. So area of a hexagon looks like this. The area is equal to 2.598a squared, where a represents one of the sides of a hexagon. Because what we know about a hexagon is that all sides are equal. So as long as we know one side of the hexagon, we know all of them. So let's see if we have all of our appropriate information. So in order to find the area of the hexagon, the only thing we need to plug in is our side there. And we are given that the side is 0.6 inches. So all we really need to do is plug in 0.6 inches into this formula. We'll calculate this one to find the area so that we could then use that answer to plug into the volume formula here and wrap that up. So for plugging in for this formula here, so 2.598 is part of the formula, and we're going to take a squared, so a is 0.6. So if we do 0.6 times 0.6, we do get 0.36 there, and we're going to take that and multiply it by 2.598. And when we multiply that, we get 0.93528. I would recommend not rounding here. If your problem asks you to round, wait to round into the very end, because otherwise you might be off just by a little bit of a rounding error. So what we figured out is the area of our hexagon. So now we're going to take this and we're going to plug it in to our volume formula. So our area is the 0.93528, and this is inches squared. So we're going to go over here to our volume formula, and what we just solved here represents A. So I'm just going to plug that in. So 0.93528, and we are going to multiply that by the height here. Our height they gave us is 4 inches. So we just need to take that and multiply it by a 4. And when we multiply that by 4, we get 3.74112 inches cubed. Remember that volume is always units cubed here. I'm going to go ahead and round this to the nearest hundredth spot. So that's 2 decimal places. So if I round this to do 2 decimal places, we get approximately 3.74 cubic inches here as the volume for this here. Otherwise, that's it for this video.